Hi, I'm Bill, and welcome back to Happy Vending. Today, we're going to be putting a new VPOS Touch from Nayax on this Merlin IV. Let's do it. Happy Vending. Well, I'm back in school here in rural Pennsylvania. Students are here, they're buying drinks. We're starting to wear masks again. But luckily, we still have a lot of students in the building and things are getting back to normal a little bit. But here in the school on my Merlin IV, for the last couple weeks, my Nayax credit card reader hasn't been working. The display has basically just been showing a bar. I've called Nayax. This reader I bought in 2017, so it's no longer in warranty, and it's only a 3G unit. The newer ones are 4G. And Nayax no longer sells this model reader, so they don't have any that they could send me as far as this one goes to change it out. So I had to buy the new model, the VPOS Touch, and this has a touch screen, whereas this one does not have a touch screen. This is a 4G one, so it should have better connection than this one had. This one never really got a good connection where we're located in this high school, so hopefully this one will be better. When I installed this one, there was no mounting space for a credit card reader here, so I actually had to drill holes in the machine. And I was told by Nayax that the new credit card reader will use those same holes, so hopefully I don't have to drill any new holes in there. I won't know until I take this one off. But it should be an easy swap. The big difference between this and this one, other than this one being touchscreen, is this one is all one unit, whereas this one has the outside reader and then it has a separate like modem inside the machine that this one connects to. Although this isn't in warranty, Nayax is giving me a $100 trade-in on this old unit, so I will have to mail the old unit back to Nayax. This new one lists for $340, but with the $100 rebate from that one, it'll be $240. It's not too bad. I'm hoping this will lead to more sales just because it's touchscreen and it's a little more modern. The most important step when you're putting in a new bill acceptor, credit card reader, coin mech, you unplug your machine. Otherwise, you can mess up the circuit board, mess up the bill acceptor, whatever. So always come over here and unplug your machine. So let me show you what's inside. So over here is where I actually have the telemeter. It's like the modem. It works on a cell signal. It has a port here for an antenna, which is also magnetic. This I just have on the top of the machine. Most of my machines, I have the antenna on the inside of the machine. The signal is strong enough. This one I had not a real good signal, so I had to put the antenna on top. I like to put the antenna inside the machine when possible, because then this is in a high school. You don't have kids playing with it. Some people actually screw them on. I just leave the magnet on. It's better for me to have the antenna inside. I'm hoping the new one has a strong enough signal that I can leave the antenna inside. The new one comes with a new antenna, so I'm not gonna use the old antenna. And then you just basically, well, the old one, you had this plug that went up to the actual reader, and then you had the interface plug, which would go into the coin mech / bill acceptor of the machine. Your machine has to be MDB compatible in order to put on a credit card reader. So this is the part which I got to send back to Nayax, and I shouldn't have to use this because the other one's all one piece and it's hopefully going to mount right up here. So I just have four Phillips screws in here, as you can see. Here comes a student over there looking to get a drink. I'm sorry, young man, the vending machine is not working right now. Got one more screw before I undo this one. I'm gonna hold on to the reader on the front so it just doesn't fall off and hit the ground. So here is the plug. There's the reader. Now, if you had to install this from scratch, the new one does come with a drill template so that you can put on your machine and you can mark off where you have to drill your holes. But like I said, I'm hoping the new one lines up with this. Let's do an unboxing. Here it is, opening it for the first time. Kind of exciting. It comes with this. It comes with this. I guess they have some type of reward program for your customers where they can do a QR code. I don't know if I'm going to bother putting that on my machine. Here we go. Look at that. I'll leave the protective coating on there until it's installed to protect it as I'm working on it. It's already mounted to this bezel, which would fit into like a pre-cut hole in your machine if you had a point of sale hole. But since I don't have that on my machine, I'm gonna take this bezel off and hopefully these four holes line up with the four holes that I have from the old credit card reader. This part I will save because I might then someday use this on a newer machine that has that point of sale hole that I'll need the bezel for. We got this bezel off and I'm realizing I'm gonna have to make some modifications to my machine, unfortunately. If you look over here, the old machine, I had the connection cord. It just had the one connection cord went through there. But now everything is integrated into this unit. So I have to not only plug in a connection cord into here, I also need to plug in the antenna. It has a different antenna than the other one with this small cord that goes in right there. And if you look at the little template for drilling your holes, these four holes are good, but the big hole, the big connection hole, you see that, is down here. And it doesn't line up with the original hole that I had for the old reader. So I'm gonna have to get a big old drill and drill a new hole right there in my machine. Let me just mark that off. So a hole like this. All right, so luckily I was able to get a big meaty drill bit. Look how big that bit is from the tech ed department, because I didn't have a drill bit here that size. I would have had to go home for that. And I did have my eye protection. You always want to use your eye protection when you're drilling in metal like this. You don't want a little shard of metal shooting in your eye. All right, right about there. The bit really isn't that sharp, so I'm going to look for a smaller drill bit and do a pilot hole first. Now time for the big one. That was a little harder to do than it should have been, only because that other hole was already drilled in there. And once the bit hit that, it just was not drilling properly. You want to make sure there's no burrs on this because you don't want to nick up your wire. And I'm also going to go get my vacuum cleaner and vacuum up all these little shards of metal. You don't want that getting in the drink. While I have the vacuum here, I'm just gonna file the burrs out of the hole. hole doesn't look real pretty, but it's gonna be covered up, and it's pretty smooth on both sides. It's not going to damage the wire. So I think we're good to move on. So let's unpackage the wiring that we need here. This part is the one that goes into the back of the reader. This is our new antenna with the new connector. I'm going to feed the two ends of the wires that I need through the hole so I can connect them up onto the reader before I screw it in place. Now it's time to connect these wires to the actual reader. The white wire goes in the long port, and the antenna wire goes right in here, and it just pushes in until it makes a snug connection. It's not like the old ones where you would have a little nut on there that locks it in. This one just pushes on. And then you get these wires down here on the right side and put the little plastic cover over this. Snap that in. And then just feed it through the hole. Have it in the gasket, and we're going to screw it in. Before you tighten your screws, you want to get all four of them in. It makes it easier to make them catch the threads if you do it that way. So I just want to start all four screws. So now that I have all four started and the wires are coming through the hole good, I can just tighten them up. There we go. So before I connect up the MDB cable, I want to just make sure I run it behind everything so that it doesn't get in the way of closing the door or these wires don't get pinched. So I send it behind all the other coin chutes and the other wires in the back here. Get it to the side of the bill acceptor. Then right here, I'm gonna unplug the MDB cable that comes from the control board that's branching off to both the bill acceptor and the coin mech. Has a little plastic, you can't really see it well, but it has a little plastic latch that you pull up and pull it out. Here it is. And that is going to plug in to the female MDB connector from the credit card reader. And then the male is going to then branch off to the bill acceptor and the coin mech, which is right here. It always has to go to your credit card reader first. That's important. That's the first point, and then it can go to the coin mech and bill acceptor. And then if your machine has a DEX plug, which are one of these quarter inch phone plugs right here, you can plug the DEX connector from the credit card reader into that. And what that does is that sends all your data as far as what drinks are being sold to your Nayax app so that you can check and see inventory. I'm just getting the wires all looking nice and neat here. I'm gonna try putting the antenna inside the machine. Like I say, you get less vandalism that way. So I'm just going to mount it right up top here and see what type of signal we get on the reader. Here it is on the front, looking pretty modern, pretty sharp. You have a swipe, you have an insert here for a chip, and you can tap to pay with a phone or a credit card that has that chip. Yeah, this is pretty high tech. At this point, we can take off the protective coating and power it up. Look at that. Look at that impressive display. Oh my God. I think this is just going to increase sales. Looks like it's ready to go. I mean, I might not even have to call Nayax. I mean, it might have been pre-programmed for my account. I say I give it a try. It says push to start.
Please select a product.
Let's select a water.
Please present your card or your mobile phone.
Select your card or your mobile phone. I'm gonna use my Visa. It has a chip on it.
Authorizing. Transaction canceled.
It says cash only now, transaction canceled. I may have to call Nayax. I'm waiting on hold for tech support. Okay, yeah, I'm at the machine. Okay. Yep. I'm in there. All right, I'm in that menu now. Do you want me to do reboot? All right, so should I unplug it? Is that what you're telling me? Or do you see it? It's showing the push to start now. All right, let me get out a credit card and give it a try.
Please select a product. Please present your card or your mobile phone. Authorizing.
That said approved. All right, we'll dispense the product.
Thank you.
All right, well, it sounds like we're good to go. Thank you very much. All right, I just got off the phone with Nayax. He had me run through it. I used my Visa card. It dispensed fine. We did have to put the antenna outside the machine for now, but it's getting a very high reading, an 18 reading, which is super high. Before I put this reader on, this machine was only getting like an 8 reading, which was low. So the 4G is definitely helping. Let me just try it one more time. Instead of the tap, I'll try my Discover card and try the chip reader and see if that works.
Please select a product.
It's good and loud, easy to understand. Let's do a regular Coke on this one.
Please present your card or your mobile phone.
I'm going to use this chip reader. For the Discover, it's saying to use the swipe. It doesn't want to use the chip reader for the Discover, so I'm going to do the swipe.
Authorizing.
So authorizing. Approved.
Thank you.
Well, there you have it. I think this thing looks really sharp. It talks. It has menus. Really easy to use, and I think it's going to really help sales here. I recommend getting the Nayax Touch credit card reader. And as always, happy vending.